All right, nice guy John Bly, welcome to Philadelphia, and welcome to Battlestations 5, the Liberty Hell, Wit Wiz.
Thank you, Big Bad John Kelso, I'm glad to be here. We turn things over now to Marvelous Mike Martin in the ring.
Marvelous Mark Martin. Nice guy, John Bly. Mark Martin's warming up the crowd with his trademark awkward dancing.
By a rat on the way in here. This is really a great day for all of us.
Yeah, have frozen salads.
That's it, that frozen salad. It's literally ice cubes in there. So, my name is Mike Martin. That's Joe Grasso. We are two trainers. We are certified professional wrestlers who wrestle on the independent circuit.
That's the grimy Scots.
Oh, that merchandise. We also run a company called Renaissance Rumble, which marries wrestling and Shakespeare plays and puts them on for people's enjoyment.
A professional wrestling inspired Shakespeare themed stunt show.
That's right. Not wrestling. Ooh. And that leads me to the next point. What you're watching here today is a training event. You are not watching a sanctioned wrestling show. You are watching students who have come together to share some of their work with you. These students have worked very hard over a legitimate 9 hours of training. I'm pointing that out because this is not something you just pick up in 9 hours.
We have crammed 3 to 6 months of pro wrestling training in 2 days.
He's not lying. So, and this is something that we've learned, we've trained with people over and over, years and years and years, and these guys put in a lot of hard work and a lot of time and talent. With that being said, again, this is a training show, so matches may stop. That's okay. Matches may restart. There may be some slowness. There may be some downtime. That's okay. You guys didn't show up for NXT, WWE, New Japan Wrestling, Ring of Honor. You guys showed up to support your friends. And that's what we're asking you to do, is to support your friends in their endeavor in this amount of learning. So, with that, I'd like to welcome to the ring our Philly crew here and our students here. Please give them a big round of applause!
Ah, the crowd is hot tonight. This capacity crowd is excited to see their friends wrestling here at Battlestations 5.
This, of course, is the Philly crew. They're led by none other than Jax, who's a tall drink of water there with the red hair.
They've trained with us. This is our Philly crew. Yeah! Yesterday at 9 o'clock, they braved the elements, came in here in this cold-ass warehouse to bump around in this ring. They are an extremely talented bunch of people, and they put in a 50-gallon drum's worth of effort and effort into this. Two times effort! Jax, this is your crew, these are your people, and this is Philly. Ladies and gentlemen, another big round of applause for our Philly people.
What is this, nice guy John Bly? And unexpected. But who are these people?
They're entering the ring. This is entirely unexpected.
Is that Sin Masseuse?
Looks like it might be, Big Bad.
Is that El Jefe de Toro?
Yes, please take the fake microphone.
Well, I appreciate what you've done here in Philly. What they've done is real cute. Renaissance Rumble started in D.C.
That's right.
Okay. Yeah!
And that is where the belt is from and where the belt should stay.
Who the hell are you?
Oh, my apologies. I'm Sin Masseuse from D.C., where the original Renaissance Rumble show started. And like I said, what y'all did definitely deserves a round of applause. Real cute.
All right, I'm gonna stop you right here, if I may. Listen, there is not a cute face up here. We are fierce, we are tough, we are freedom, we are Philadelphia.
That sounds like a challenge.
That's great. you. Oh. I want you.
Is happy to accept your challenge.
Wait. No. I'm just. Oh,
that's
just...
right. We'll see you in the ring.
No takesy backsies.
Well, nice guy, John Blyant. Sounds like we have a bit of a rivalry going on here. The originators versus the innovators.
I don't think it's much of a rivalry. Renaissance Rumble started in D.C. And who is this?
I don't think I...
What?
I'm getting a peek of that shirt. John Blyant, you don't think. You don't think.
Could it be?
Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce to you the Purple Parrot.
What's the Purple Parrot?
We haven't heard anything out of the Purple Parrot since the last Battlestations. I thought he was dead.
He was from D.C., transplanted to Philly. He was a champion. He was put through the ringer last time. Lost, dejected. I don't know. Parrot, why are you here? What are you doing here in Philly?
This crowd on pins and needles to find out what the Purple Parrot is doing here today.
So wait, you're from D.C., you live in Philly, who are you with?
Boo!
Yeah! Ha ha! This
Purple Parrot, silent but deadly. Nice guy, John Bly.
Well, this will be an interesting event. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Battlestations 5, Liberty Hell. I'm throwing it over to our first commercial. Let's hear it!
Do you love everything about Shakespeare, except for all those words? Have you ever wished that Hamlet would stop complaining and do something about his problems before Act 5? Are tights simply not masculine enough for you? Then trade in those tights for a big manly unitard and step into the arena as Renaissance Rumble presents Shakespeare in the Ring! Join your host, William Shakespeare, as he presents his most famous fights as they were always meant to be seen, with less exposition and more headlocking, body-slamming violence. Playing this fall at the Maryland Renaissance Festival, Saturdays and Sundays, including Labor Day Monday. Renaissance Rumble, no holds barred.
Here at the Renaissance Rumble Arena, talking to Cat Lady. I'm really intrigued to hear what she has to say. Cat Lady, what do you have to say about tonight and your opponent?
That little Miss Sunshine Stephanie comes up here talking about this purple parrot or whatever, but she made it sound like a real parrot. I thought I was going to get lunch out of this. And no one promises food to a cat and doesn't give food to a cat. She may be little Miss Sunshine, but I hunt at night. She comes up here from the land of law and order. But I fight with the laws of the jungle. I may be fighting for Philly, but I'm originally from Jersey, where it's illegal to declaw your cats. So bitch better watch out. This kitty's got claws. Pussies get a bad rap, but I ain't no scaredy cat.
Those are some strong words from Cat Lady, John Bly.
Strong words indeed.
I'm here with Stephanie from D.C. She's matching up tonight against the enigmatic and always unpredictable Cat Lady. Stephanie, Cat Lady, big tall order. What do you got to say about it?
Well, even if you might be saying she's a big tall order, I think cats are pretty small, and I can step over them if I need to get to where I need to be. And of course, you know where I've come from. You know my story, my background with the bird that shall not be named. But now, I'm here, And I'm proud to be who I am. I am unapologetically me. I am Stephanie, and I am a star. And you know what the brightest star in the universe is? The sun. And that cat lady, she's about to get burnt.
Wow, I love it. I can't wait to see it. Sending it back to you at ringside.
You know, John Bly, I think that Stephanie is just too sweet and innocent to be involved in the violence of professional wrestling.
Now, I would have to disagree with you there. She says the bird shall not be named, but I'll name him. It was the purple parrot, and she screwed him over.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. She's too kind and soft-hearted a person to be involved in such violence, to be involved with such heinous, horrible people as the purple parrot. And I don't think that she'll be able to handle herself against Cat Lady.
Well, on that, I think we can agree. Cat Lady is simply too much for a weakling like Stephanie to handle in the ring.
No, I'm twisting my words, boy. Cat Lady rubbing up against the audience. I mentioned earlier this is a capacity crowd. I just want to explain the capacity of this warehouse basement is only 25 people. We just happen to have some extra chairs.
The line outside, however, is tremendously long.
It stretches to Pittsburgh. Cat Lady, true to cat form, taking her time getting in the ring.
Cat Lady has been coaxed into the room. Now let's see if in true cat form she wants to go back out again right away.
Hailing from D.C., the lawful streets of D.C., weighing in at 17 bottles of sunshine, Stephanie!
How can these people boo Stephanie? She enters to queen, for Christ's sake.
I think this crowd is right to boo. I think anyone who watched the horrible actions at Battlestations 4 where she betrayed her partner.
That's ridiculous. You're starting to say Stephanie betrayed the purple parrot?
When you're in someone's corner, you're supposed to have their back no matter what, even if they're cheating.
The purple parrot did his share of cheating at Battlestations 4. Look at how Stephanie's joy and love of life is winning over this angry Philadelphia crowd. You have to wonder at this point, Bly, is Cat Lady going to be able to maintain her interest in this match long enough to win it?
And Chief Referee.
Precision Jim Frank will be officiating this match.
Ring the bell!
Cat Lady with a foreign object that completely backfired. Stepping off to a good start with that armbar.
Such language out of such a foul woman.
You may be a little bit sunshine, from... but all I hear is a big ball of gas.
You know, Bly, I think this is the first time I've ever seen a human being wrestle a cat. The hammerlock reversal there from Catman. Stephanie would never cheat.
That's not how I play.
Cheating is in the eye of the beholder.
Oh, are you allergic to cats?
Cat Lady, taking advantage of her own natural allergens, to try to incapacitate Stephanie. I think that constitutes an illegal item.
I disagree, Big Bad. This is just brilliant strategy here. Cat Lady, knowing that her opponent was allergic to her, is using proximity as a weapon.
Cat Lady once again to the ropes to break a hold.
You don't even have a tail!
And Cat Lady is distracted by some dangling string in the ring corner. Stephanie going for a body slam. Eye rake by Cat Lady.
Cats are notorious for their unwillingness to be picked up, and they returned with a nasty scratch. Oh.
Cat Lady's got Stephanie. A vicious body slam from Cat Lady to Stephanie. And the pin.
She pounces.
Biting. She was biting. What kind of competitor do you think this Cat Lady is? Boy?
I know. There are children present.
The vicious choke.
Two. Three.
Four.
All right. Precision. Jim Frank was on it. Sin Basus is trying to tempt Stephanie into cheating with the silly string. But Stephanie is too good a person for it. Oh. Vicious back rake from Cat Lady to Stephanie.
Stephanie will need some antibiotics after that.
You can't help but think those cat claws must have slashed her skin to ribbons.
Who knows where that cat lady's been?
It was an Irish whip reversal from Stephanie, sending Cat Lady into the corner. Cat Lady taking a much needed rest there. Oh, and Stephanie misses the elbow. Schoolgirl roll up. And precision Jim Frank counts the three. I have to say, Bly, when this match started, I wasn't sure that Cat Lady would have the attention span to stick with it. I thought she might just wander out of the ring to go find some balls to push around.
Well, I think the lesson here is that it shows the importance of having someone in your corner. Stephanie ignored Sin Masseuse, and now she is on the losing end of this match.
I'm not cheating anymore. I know that's what happened with the purple pair, but I don't cheat. I'm Stephanie. I'm on my own.
We win by any means necessary.
But we don't have to do this. We can win on our own merits.
Oh, heaven, the DC crew is attacking one of their own.
Yeah, showing the power of teamwork. Good for them.
Teamwork, my foot.
All right, look, you're with us now, right? You're feeling.
All right,
that's right. Sisterly love, animal love. Not a gender.
Yeah.
It's not a gender love.
Yeah, that's right. Right, Stephanie.
Well, Bly, it seems like Stephanie is moving to Philadelphia.
Once again showing her complete lack of loyalty to her hometown of D.C.
Well, can you blame her? Real estate prices in Philadelphia are way better than in D.C.
Mike Martin here at the Renaissance Rumble Arena with Lord Kensington and Johnny John. They're here to tell us about the Purple Parrot. He hasn't selected a side. We don't know what he's like. Fellas, tell me what you're going to do about it.
Well, first of all, it's Jimmy John, all right? Get it right. Now, we're here, and we don't know anything about this purple parrot, all right? He's from D.C., came up here a little bit ago. He's a real unpredictable kind of a guy, and we need to make him choose a side. We got to find out what he's made of, and I think I'll be able to take him down a peg, find out what he's got, see if he can really fight.
That's right. Now, look, on top of that, we all know the bottom line here is this D.C. crew's coming up to our city, like big government coming in on the little guy. All right, so we got to show them how it works here in Philly. And then after that, my man Jimmy John is going to take this purple parrot, this purple pigeon guy, and see if he's got what it takes to fight in Philly. Because Philly brings the class when we whoop that ass.
Big words from Jimmy John and Lord Kensington. Let's see what the purple parrot has to say. Here here at the Renaissance Rumble Arena, eagerly awaiting the arrival of the Purple Parrot. We heard some strong words from Jimmy John and Lord Kensington. We're going to see what the Purple Parrot has to say. I'm excited. I know you're excited to see it. If the Purple Parrot shows, this is going to be an event. We're all going to... And here he is!
The parrot talks. So the question now is, who is this guy? Who is the Purple Parrot, Colin Sheen? After all the betrayal, after all the embarrassment, and after all the humiliation, who is he? Why is he here? All great questions. And as soon as I find answers to them, I'll let you know. Now there's another question that's floating around. Which side is he on? Where does his loyalty lie? Is the parrot Team DC, where he spent a lot of time? Or is he now going to be on the side of the place where he now flaps his feathers in Philly? Now, what a lot of people don't realize that they need to remember is I became the person I am at a TV studio in Orlando, Florida. But it's a valid question. Where does my loyalty lie? Whose side am I on? And I'll tell you, it's a pretty easy question for me to answer. I'm going to be on the side that I have always been on and always will be on, and that's mine. So Jimmy John, I guess I'm facing you. I don't know what's going to happen. But if you or anybody else on Team Philly decides to mess with me, you'll hear about it. You'll get a mouth of feathers. You'll get the silver monkey statue thrown in your face. The temple guards will come and take you behind the gate. You'll never be seen again. Whatever. But so help me God, if anyone gets in my way, Team Philly or Team DC, they're all going down. Because I'm the Purple Parrot, Colin Sheen, and I don't care how many times I got knocked down, Olmec always liked us best.
Big words, a lot of questions answered. Can he back it up? I'm excited to see it. Sending it back to ringside.
John Bly, some strong words on both sides of the equation here.
Now, Marvelous Mark Martin said that there were a lot of questions answered, but not as many questions answered as questions raised. We might as well call him the Violet Enigma.
Coming to the ring.
You know, the Purple Parrot is nearly unrecognizable under that mask.
John, accompanied by his bro from Kensington at 250 pounds, Lord Kensington!
You know, Lord Kensington, Bly, is part of the legendary Kensington family. When Philadelphia was the capital of the United States many, many years ago, the Kensingtons were one of the most important families. One of the most important families in Philadelphia.
You would have me believe that this man is a direct descendant of that line?
I believe so.
Well, then I need to make his acquaintance.
And if my notes here are correct, that hat is the actual hat worn by his great-great-grandfather when he wrestled George Washington.
And making his way to the ring, weighing in at 160
feel like you're in the presence
pounds,
of history.
Hailing from Nickelodeon Studios in Orlando, Florida, Colin Sheen, the Purple Parrot!
Jimmy John there, tearing off his jersey.
Here comes the Purple Parrot. I'll tell you, whatever else you say about this man, he is certainly a fascinating figure. He's gone from the lowest of the lows to the highest of the highs and right back again.
You have to think, Bly, that Jimmy John is going to be in a disadvantage here, facing a veteran like the Purple Parrot.
Should I ring the bell?
We're going to ring this bell. We're going to begin this match.
The Seems to be some confusion. Precision Jim Frank insisting that the mask be removed, but the purple parrot refuses.
I don't know. I think it was heads up. Heads.
What's going on here? Is the purple parrot refusing to take part in this match?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
The parrot seems to be implying that Jimmy John is beneath him, and it's a countout.
10.
Bly, it's a countout.
I cannot believe what I've just seen. Now, we've seen the parrot lose a lot, and we've seen the parrot win. We've never seen the parrot walk away.
Oh, but you're not man enough to go and get him.
What?
I didn't train you up to just stand here.
Why don't you go get him?
Oh, all right. No, you came here for a fight. You're going to have a fight.
Lord Kensington just threw his cigar into his great-great-great-grandfather's top hat.
What is this? What is this, Tuesday?
Kensington does not like that Jimmy John would not chase the purple parrot.
And now it's brother against brother in the city of brotherly love.
He's my boy. But I gotta school him. Oh, all right.
It'll be interesting to see how these two men square off. They clearly know each other very well. Should know each other's styles. Know each other's strengths and weaknesses.
If Lord Kensington taught Jimmy John everything he knows, then this should be a short match.
Training arm ringers.
I expect to see the expertise of the aristocracy shining through here.
Bly, do you think that because Kensington is from the famed Kensington family, he is inherently a better human being?
Well, I wasn't going to say it, but yes. Yes, I do, Big Bad.
I feel like you were implying it. I didn't just pull that out of the air. All right, two men showing respect to each other. Fowler elbow tie. Hammerlock by Jimmy John. Kensington trying to fight his way out of it. And a reversal.
Yeah, you like it. Oh, no.
Another reversal.
Oh, he's caught in that hammer lock like it's the U.S. tax system.
Go again. 1, 2, 3.
And Precision Jim Frank will not allow a man to, or a woman, to continue a hold when their victim is on the ropes. Kensington once again gets the ropes.
It's a smart strategy.
1, 2, 3.
Ooh. And a chin buster from Kensington to Jimmy John. Sweeps the legs and goes for the pin.
Hurry up! He's up!
Kick out at one.
Hurry up!
Ooh.
I have to say, in physical prowess, they seem to be equally matched, but there seems to be a clear difference in mental prowess.
Some sort of secret Philadelphia handshake exchange there. Now the trading chops. Vicious knife edge chops. Oh, and Kensington delivers the chop to Jimmy John's Jimmies. Kensington delivers a vicious reverse neckbreaker.
Okay. Come on, choke! 1, 2, 3!
It is a blatant choke from Kensington. Precision Jim Frank won't let it, won't stand for it.
1, 2, 3!
This is just blatant disrespect from
Kensington. He's got till 5. He's got till 5.
It's clear now that Kensington doesn't just want to win this match. He wants to humiliate Jimmy John. Once again,
Lord Kensington making excellent use of his time. He understands the rules, and he's using them to best effect.
He's breaking the rules. He's blatantly
choking. He's got till
choking.
Five. He's got till five.
Jimmy John with a splash in the corner and a body slam. Vicious body slam from Jimmy John to Kensington. This is the elbow.
This one's for Gritty.
Another missed elbow.
And for Gritty.
How can you both miss?
Gritty, the horrifying mascot of the Philadelphia Flyers.
And noted anti-fascist symbol.
Oh, hell no.
Was that El Jefe de Toro with an...
Something happened in the corner, but I didn't see it. And the point is that...
Jim Frank with the double disqualification? Is that what just happened?
Give me a broom.
It's hard to understand what's gone on in that pandemonium.
I think Jim Frank is just reiterating that in Philadelphia there are no winners, only losers.
Mike Martin here with DC native Raven. She's going to be matching up against Tina, Warrior Princess, in the Renaissance Rumble Arena. Raven, I'm excited to see your match. What are you going to do to Tina, and what do you have to say to her?
Well, for starters, her name's stupid, and I'm going to kick her ass, because she's just a bunch of Philly trash, and that's about it.
Wow. Wow, strong words for a petite but fierce woman. She's going to bring it. Does Tina have it? We're going to see. I'm talking to her next.
Short and to the point from Raven.
I'm here with Tina, Warrior Princess. I just spoke to Raven, who had some strong words. She called you Philly trash. I don't...
She called me what? Listen, Raven, you're real smart, but I'm going to show you how we do it up here in Philly. And, okay, while it's true I might be Philly trash is better than DC's biggest treasure, right? So come on up in Philly, and you're going to get some. Oh, I'm done.
Oh, I can come. Okay.
Yeah, thanks.
Thanks. Tina, Warrior Princess. Whew. Raven's got her work cut out for her. I can't wait to see this. Going back to ringside.
Well, I think Tina had every reason to feel insulted by the unkind words of Raven.
Look, if the words fit, the words fit.
Scheduled for one fall.
She said herself, she admitted to being Philly trash.
First, coming to the ring, weighing in it, why don't you guess? Coming from none of my business, Raven!
Looked like Raven thought she would take a walk through this hostile Philly crowd, and then she thought the better of it.
She's working that runway. You know, she's a model.
Come on, Tina. Let's go. Today. No one's supposed to like me. I don't know.
Making her way to the ring, weighing in at 150 pounds, standing at 5 foot nothing from South Philly, Tina.
And the crowd does love their hometown girl, Bly. This match is serious, Bly. She's taking off her earrings.
It's usually a good sign that some violence is sure to follow.
I hope Tina remembers to pick that gum up at the end of the match.
Well, I think it's just despicable the way she is disrespecting the ring.
These two ladies trading armors. you have to think, Bly, that Raven is giving up some power to Tina. And Tina appears to be the stronger of the two. Raven's going to have to rely on her technical abilities to be able to triumph in this match.
Well, we'll see what her technical abilities are, but as a model, she is surely no stranger to the fierce drag-em-out, beat-em-down world of girl-on-girl violence.
Collar elbow tap. Tina comes around with the waistline. Reversal. Another reversal, and Tina's back in control, but Raven has the ropes. Tina is arguing with the ref, and that is not going to get her anywhere.
Meanwhile, Raven is making excellent use of the ropes, allowing her opponent to wear herself down.
I get the impression that Tina would actually prefer that this match be a no disqualifications match, which would eliminate the stipulation that when one touches the ropes, they get out of the hold they're in. Vicious boots in the corner from Raven.
Notice there was no argument with Precision Jim Frank because Raven understands the rules and is using them to her best advantage.
No, get off!
I think there's a difference between using the rules and abusing the rules, Bly. Raven standing on Tina.
Get up!
So the tactic here appears to be to work on the midsection so that Tina won't be able to catch her breath. You can't breathe, you can't wrestle. Full Nelson lock from Raven to Tina.
Tina.
Oh. Snapmare. No shoulder stretch.
You still in it?
Oh, there's no way. There's no way. She's tapping. She's tapping to this for sure.
No, she can't tap. Blind. Just her hands are locked up in that vicious stretch. Raven standing on Tina's chest.
Using her opponent to increase her own height, which will further her career in the modeling industry.
It looked like Sin Masseuse was trying to offer some powder there, but it backfired on her.
I think you're just seeing things, Big Bad. Sin Masseuse is clearly just out there for emotional support.
Tina appears to be trying for a Boston Crab of some sort. Yeah, one leg Boston Crab. And Raven taps. There was some excellent technical knowledge by Tina, and she has remembered to pick up her gum.
Hey, sweetie, can I have my ears back?
Oi. Listen up, you sheep-shaggin' jacobites. Uncle Angus here. Representing the greatest Scottish tag team to grace these United Colonies, the Grimy Scots. These lads hail from my hometown, the greatest city in the planet, Edinburgh. That means they're Scottish, and they are proud of it. We've decided to drag ourselves out of the pubs to show you Yanks what a real fight looks like. Between the speed and finesse of Hamish Stewart and the brute strength and stamina of Grizzly Duncan McBain, they are the unstoppable Scottish force. Would ya look at them? Aren't they amazing? Making crybabies out of their opponents. moment. Oh, don't cry, ya wee baby. Tis only a clothesline. They're an eloquent bunch, too.
Hold your wrist, you poor man! You've got the bomb at the window! You also...
Like the finest sonnet to Shakespeare. So, keep your eyes on the highlands, lowlands, and dive bars, because the grimy Scots are coming to your town to show you what real Scottish champions look like. And if you get in our way, tell them what will happen, Grizzly.
Our opponents might take the high road, but we always take the low!
And we're back to Battlestations 5, the Liberty Hell Wit Wiz.
Renaissance Rumble Arena, it is my esteemed pleasure. We have a new combatant here that's going to come out here. His name is Boss Atkinson.
Adkisson. Now everyone talks about the Von Erich brothers. The six Von Erich brothers. Jackie, Kevin, David, Kerry, Mike, and Chris. But what the world does not know is that there was a seventh brother, a seventh Von Erich boy. And you were looking at him. See that dirty, dirty son of a bitch, Fritz Von Erich. He took it upon himself to sexually violate my mama. And you know what? Then I was born. I have got the Von Erich blood inside me. He paid my mom to keep her mouth shut, but I ain't keeping quiet no more. I have come to Renaissance Rumble to reclaim my glory. But I'm not gonna take that name of that goose-stepping sympathizer Von Erich. I'm going by the real name. I'm going by Adkisson. And I'm making a challenge to all you out there at Renaissance Rumble. You may have some of the best moves. You may be some of the best wrestling talent. But I am a Von Erich. And I have got the Von Erich legacy flowing through my veins and flowing through my body. So I'm going to come out there and make an open challenge to any of you. And it is time for you to embrace the pain.
Well, what a revelation that was. This will be exciting. I can't wait to see it. We're going back to ringside.
That was some unparalleled intensity from Boss Atkinson. Illegitimate child of Fritz Von Erich?
I like the cut of this man's jib.
Way to the ring.
He came to Renaissance Rumble for glory, Bly.
Texas, Boss Atkinson!
Now, if he wanted glory, it'd be very easy for him to just accept the Von Erich name.
It would. He seems to be a man who wants to earn his own glory. And obviously carries a grudge against the Von Erichs. But it was an open challenge, Bly. Who do you think is going to step up now to take on this mountain of a man?
After such strong words from Boss Atkinson, I can't imagine that anyone would be up to the challenge of entering this ring.
Shut up!
No love lost between Atkinson and this Philly crowd.
Yeah. How does it feel to be in the presence of greatness?
Yes. It feels pretty good, Brian. It feels good.
You're welcome.
I am here to claim Renaissance Rumble for myself because I have that right as a Von Erich. Me stepping into the ring entitles me to be world champion. As far as I'm concerned, I am the uncrowned champion. And I am entitled, just like my brothers, Kevin, Kerry, and David to make out with all the women in the arena.
I don't feel like that logically flows, Black.
No, no, he's citing obscure wrestling rules of Prima Nocta.
Hey, Davy Crockett, you keep your mouth shut.
complain. You think that you're the only bastard boy here?
Who in the hell do you think you are, you son of a bitch?
Well, I'll tell you who my daddy is, Terry Gordy. You might have heard of him. One of the fabulous Freebirds.
Oh. No.
Back in 1982, your daddy and my daddy had a little bit of a fisticuffs. But I don't know why that should remain in the past. So, if you got an open challenge, I mean, I know that you're bigger, stronger, and you know what, Butterball? That's okay with me, because my name is Roadkill Jackrabbit, and I'm 100 pounds away from California.
So it seems, Bly, we are seeing a resurrection of the age-old feud between the fabulous Freebirds and the Von Erich family, but in the form of two bastard sons who hate their fathers.
It does seem strange that these two men who hate their fathers would go to battle in the name of their fathers, but here we are.
If there's one thing to be learned here today, Bly, it's that Philadelphia is lousy with bastards. Jack Rabbit himself called it out. He looks like he's 100 pounds soaking wet. He is giving up an enormous size and strength disadvantage to Atkinson. So far managing to hold his own there.
Looks to me like Boss Atkinson is simply playing with him. Toying with his opponent.
Atkinson, who has a very close crew cut, trying to convince Precision Jim Frank that his hair was pulled. I've got to say, Bly, that I am very surprised by how well Jack Rabbit has been able to comport himself in this match so far.
Okay. Same for here. 1, 2. Why don't you count on the slugger, ref?
And that just goes to show you that technique can triumph over brute strength.
Technique can only take you so far, though. At some point, a giant slab of meat will overcome a small, insignificant, puny speck of a man.
Well, Rabbit might prove himself other than insignificant here in this match.
Jack Rabbit attempted a waist lock there, but his tiny arms were almost not sufficient to wrap themselves around the mighty behemoth that is Boss Atkinson.
Atkinson is now clearly in control.
Come on over. How about my daddy's famous claw, huh?
The Von Erich claw.
Rabbit blocks.
Bly, if Atkinson had gotten that claw placed, this match would surely be over.
The claw is truly devastating. It's the same claw he used to sexually violate his mother.
That Von Erich used. The vicious chops. Atkinson with a series of knife-edge chops. But Rabbit has turned it around and is delivering chops of his own. More chops from Atkinson. He's going to chop through the man.
I'm As they continue to exchange chops, the question becomes, when will one of these two men use their safe word?
No safe words in a wrestling ring. Bly, you should know that well. The only way to get out of it is to get yourself pinned, right, to submit.
Always thinking.
Or to disqualify yourself.
Davey Grumpy, bitch of the wild.
Jack Rabbit hops right up into a body slam.
That's right.
Atkinson should just pin the man and end this. How much abuse can Rabbit take?
Now I have to agree with you there, Big Bad. It's time to end this. Put the man out of his misery.
Huh? Huh? All right, come on. You want to play? Come on.
Rabbit ducks two clotheslines and delivers a shoulder block. Ineffective. Atkinson with a knee right to the breadbasket, completely stopping all of Rabbit's momentum.
Hey, go ahead, crawl away.
If Rabbit had any sense, he would crawl his way out of this ring and out of the building.
This is truly an
embarrassing, devastating display of supremacy by Boss Atkinson.
And a second splash in the corner from Atkinson to Rabbit. Rabbit gets up. Will he take a third block? Atkinson bringing the claw. He misses. Rabbit with the roll-up. And that's it. Rabbit with an unexpected, unbelievable win.
I cannot believe what I just saw. Can you believe it, Big Bad?
I believe it because I saw it, but I'm very surprised, Bly.
After quite an explosive event in that ring, it is my pleasure to talk to Sin Masseuse and El Jefe del Toro. Big things happened in that ring, and I'm going to set it straight here. Sin, you and Jax, I can't wait to see it. What's going on? You in the ring with her?
I don't think this is necessary. I mean, what they put together up here was really cute, and she is great, and they've clearly put together a lot of hard work, and I think we've proven everything we need to. I don't think that this is necessary.
Sin Masseuse, we need you out there. You are the best that DC has to offer. You are the best that Renaissance Rumble has to offer. The challenge has been issued, and you cannot back down now. You will go out there. You will destroy Jax. And DC will be supreme.
Fine.
Wow. I can't wait to see this. Explosive things are happening in the ring. The best of DC, Sin Masseuse. The best of Philly Jax. I'm excited. Sending it back to you at ringside. Jax, I had the dubious pleasure of talking to El Jefe del Toro and Sin Masseuse. They had some big words about what happened in the ring and what's going to happen tonight. Do you have anything to say about that?
Oh, I got a lot to say about that. They come up from D.C., but I'll tell you what, they are going down. You don't come up here and call us cute? She came in, she called us cute. Let me ask you, is the Liberty Bell cute? Is Ben Franklin cute? Is Independence cute? I think not. So, Sin, I'm looking at you. I will see you in the ring, and you are going down.
Wow. I am excited. This is a hot matchup, and you should be too. Sending it back to you at ringside.
Bly, it seems like Sin Masseuse is not eager to get herself involved in this match.
Well, the thing that struck me was El Jefe referring to Sin Masseuse as the best that DC and Renaissance Rumble had to offer. It's like he doesn't even know that Eel O'Neil exists.
That is true. Eel O'Neil is extraordinarily underrated and unfortunately was not part of this invasion. I wonder, is he not proud enough to stand up for his city?
Well, it's a mystery that remains to be solved someday.
Sin Masseuse with a look of worry on her face.
Now, we've seen Sin Masseuse in action before, but these days she prefers her role as a manager, so it is a rare sight to see her in a ring.
You have to wonder, Bly, has she been pushed into this by El Jefe? Is she an unwilling participant?
It appears that that may be the case.
And her competitor, hailing from the city of Philadelphia, weighing in at 1776 pounds of pure freedom, Joe!
I feel like Marvelous Mark Martin might need to check his stats there a little bit. He just announced that Jax weighs 1,776 pounds.
Jax is entering this ring because she disagrees with being called cute. I have to say, I think she's right. I would use the term adorable.
And it seems like this Philadelphia crowd agrees with you. Definitely a fan favorite here in Philly.
And you, sir, is nothing but a problem this whole show. What? You need to be off the ring and out of the ring curb.
Yeah!
Precision Jim Frank will not stand for El Jefe del Toro being involved in this match.
He's told El Jefe, get out of this ring and don't come back until you find Eel O'Neill.
These two ladies are sizing each other up. Collar elbow tie. Masseuse gets the rope and the hold is broken. So far, these ladies appear to be pretty evenly matched, Bly.
I would give the early edge to Sin Masseuse only because these types of holds are exactly like her massage work from her previous career.
I see. You think she's going to carry that experience into the wrestling ring?
She knows exactly which pressure points to hit to inflict serious damage to her opponent.
These two ladies clearly hate each other, Bly. They are coming at each other with a level of aggression and viciousness that I haven't seen in a long time.
Well, regardless of who wins, I think Jax has certainly proven her point. There is nothing cute about the violence on display in this ring right now.
Masseuse is reaching for the ropes. Well, she has got the ropes. Masseuse firmly in control. Jack's in the corner, and she's got that leg wrapped around that bottom rope. She's not only is she violating the rules to injure her opponent, Bly, she's basically taunting the referee by keeping an illegal hold until the count of four, repeatedly.
And also, if she were to do that exact same hold in a massage parlor, she could charge more money for it.
Masseuse sweeps the knee of Jax. And now she's choking. Bly, this is a blatant disregard for the rules. Blatant.
Well, there it is in return. There's clearly no love lost between these two women.
Jack's in control now with some boost directly to the breadbasket. Her knee is injured. Her knee is injured from had a shoulder block to the knee earlier by Masseuse.
I'm sure the injury can't be too bad, or Precision Jim Frank would check on her.
In a situation where Sin Masseuse is giving up several inches of height to her opponent, it makes sense for her to go after the knee, going after the knee once again. Because if Jax can't stand, she loses her height advantage, Bly.
Best way to deal with those long legs of Jax is to cut them right out from underneath her. I agree, Big Bad.
Jax reverses. Oh, and Jax reverses that ankle lock into an ankle lock of her own. Powder! Powder! Stephanie delivers powder to Jax.
Stephanie. The most important thing, though, is that Stephanie is displaying teamwork for the first time in her life.
Stephanie was welcomed in by the Philadelphia crew and now betrays them by throwing powder in the face of Jack. This is a... Who knew that Stephanie could be capable of such guile?
Some sort of industrial strength lie.
And we're back.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, this brings us to our main event. Entering this match ready for one fall.
One fall.
Coming down to the ring, weighing in at 250 pounds, hailing from the labyrinth, El Jefe Del Toro.
I hear that Philly is home to the Eagles, but all I've seen so far are chicken shits.
El Jefe Del Toro equating the Philadelphia football team, the Eagles, with chicken shit.
That's the sort of language that will get a man fired from Chick-fil-A.
Well, we have come here and we have faced every last one of your Philly wrestlers. Okay? And you put up a good show, but in the end, we're still the ones holding this. And there isn't a single one of you Philadelphians left who can do a damn thing about it.
Well, El Jefe Del Toro is not going to win over this Philadelphia crowd to talk like that.
That music, could it be?
Is the Purple Parrot coming to represent?
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way back to the ring, weighing in at 160 pounds, from Nickelodeon Studios in Orlando, Florida, the Purple Parrot, Colin Sheen!
Does this mean that the Purple Parrot is standing for the people of Philadelphia?
I think he said before he only stands for himself.
Wow. You know, sometimes the parrot just feels like there's way, way too much pride in the world. People always say, you gotta take pride where you come from. I say, if you don't wake up every day having no pride and hating yourself, you're not doing it right. So as you can imagine, I don't give a damn about this Philly versus DC, who's better, whatever. I don't care. But I'll tell you something I do care about. I'll tell you something that makes me more angry than anything else in the world. Bull ease!
Purple Parrot making a terrible tongue. Terrible pun.
El Jefe del Toro. What the heck happened to you, man? I respected you. I was happy to call you my ally. But now you come here and you bring your DC crew and hijack the show and terrorize all these people and all these great, great wrestlers? For what? What? The Ren Rumble chapter in the capital of one of the greatest nations in the world. What, that wasn't good enough for you? I don't get it, man. I just don't get it. But I'll tell you something I do get. You're a bully, plain and simple. And I've been jerked around long enough, way too many times, and I've been... had my beak clipped enough to know that I don't tolerate bullies. So I tell you what I'm going to do about it. You and me, right now, if no one in your Philly crew is going to take care of this bully problem, then maybe I will.
Woo! Woo!
And I'll tell you something else, sir. I can't believe I'm about to say this, but I will be proud to kick your big ass all over the city of brotherly love.
The Purple Parrot comes out and announces that he is against the concept of pride and that he hates bullying.
Indeed, and then at the end says that he would be proud, even though he hates pride, to be the victor here this evening.
The Purple Parrot is clearly giving up a lot of size against El Jefe here. Bly. He has the early advantage.
Oh, that advantage is gone just like that.
Those two men trading armors. Del Toro gets the world.
Big Bad, I have to ask. That was a very long speech from the Purple Parrot. Did you feel like we were sitting in on his therapy session?
I think the Purple Parrot has a lot to say, Bly, and he had the opportunity to say it.
Well, we'll see if El Jefe can shut him up for good.
Del Toro shrugging off the parrot, throwing him the entire way across the ring.
Perilously close to knocking out Precision Jim Frank.
Bly, I'm looking over to the audience over there, this capacity crowd here in Philadelphia, and I can't help but notice it appears that former Renaissance Rumble champion Senor Machismo is in the audience.
Oh, Senor Machismo, let's see if we can get him over here to the desk.
Let's wave him over. Right now, Del Toro is literally carrying the weight of the Purple Parrot on his back. Parrot needs to break this holder. He's going to be disqualified. Del Toro with a low bro. Did Precision Jim Frank not see it? It looks like he didn't.
I'm sorry, Big Bad. I'm back with you. I just wandered out to the audience. And I have with me none other than Senor Machismo.
You do? Senor Machismo, do we have another headset for you?
Amigo. Amigo.
Yeah!
I'm delighted to be here. Amigo.
Senor Machismo, we're delighted to have you.
Oh, you're very delighted, yes.
Machismo, what brings you to Philadelphia today?
I do enjoy the cheesesteak.
Yeah. Cheesesteaks. Let's get back to the action here. Machismo, if you were in the ring with Del Toro, how do you think you would handle this situation?
It's difficult for me to say, senor. Del Toro is a great competitor.
No, Senor Machismo, you're not giving yourself enough credit. You would crush this man. You'd give him the old five chops of doom, wouldn't you?
amigo, my five chops of doom. Deadly. I would not kill this man. I would defeat him with the pinfall.
Machismo, you are clearly a competitor who stands above all others. Look at this. Backbreaker from Del Toro to the parrot. He's got him bent in half. How could the parrot possibly recover from this? That looks like a pin. Why is Precision Jim Frank not counting this pin? The parrot kicks out.
Precision Jim Frank seemed to realize his mistake and started his count at two.
Senor Machismo, you have to go? Oh, I see. Your cheesesteak order is ready. Well, enjoy your day.
Thank you very much, Senor Machismo. You're welcome back here anytime.
Adios. Adios.
The parrot has finally taken... Oh! A stone-cold stunner from Purple Parrot to Del Toro.
Big Bad, I cannot believe what I'm hearing from this capacity crowd. They were chanting for the Purple Parrot.
Well, he is here to represent the people of Philadelphia.
I know, but this may be the first time that anyone has ever cheered on the Purple Parrot. And I do include his mother when I say that.
These two men had the same idea, the double clothesline, and both men are down now. Stephanie is taking out her frustrations on the Purple Parrot.
Oh, Stephanie laid out by Jax. I have to say, it warms my heart to see it.
Well, it looks like the alliance between the Purple Parrot and the Philadelphia crew here is complete here, Bly.
You get the whole.
Oh, it looks like he's about to get those horns.
Del Toro misses with the horns in the corner. The parrot with the crossbody. Parrot, go for the pin. Oh, Del Toro's up. Oh. The parrot delivered some sort of a flying DDT to Del Toro, and that's what it took. Like,
unbelievable stamina. I personally thought the parrot was on the receiving end of that blow, but he popped right back up.
The parrot has shown that the love in the city of brotherly love is undeniable. He has been welcomed by the Philadelphia crew here, and he stands in solidarity with them with the Renaissance Rumble Championship.
What a remarkable journey for the Purple Parrot. Wait. It's not enough for him that he's won. He wants to talk again.
All right, let's get one thing straight. I was damn proud to kick El Jefe Toro's ass. But, just so there's no confusion, I'm still not Team Philly.
What?
Look. This is the only team that I'll ever play for. This is my story. This is my redemption. And like it or not, you're going to be seeing a whole lot more of this as long as you keep up with Renaissance Rumble. Yeah. But in the meantime, I'm not on your side. But I think you guys earned this for today.
Yeah.
All right.
Purple Parrot making it clear that his alliance with the Philly squad is merely temporary.
Spirit, right? Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause for everybody! Come on!
And the Philadelphia contingent is awfully, obviously very proud of what they've done here today. And I have to say, I think they've represented themselves and their city well. Why?
I think everyone here this evening has something to be proud of. Some more than others, but...
Congratulations to everyone, Bly. Congratulations to you.
Oh, thank you. Congratulations to you, Big Bad.
Thank you. Congratulations to Senor Machismo.
Oh, wherever he is, congratulations, Senor Machismo.
We've all done a great job.